So in this presentation, and what we're going to be covering today is managing multiple domains in G Suite, or what was called G Suite is now Google Workspace. And our business is all about helping small and medium-sized business owners to get the best out of your tech. And what that means is we want to help your tech be an unfair advantage inside your business. We want you to make sure that you've got the right strategies in place and that your technology is actually set up correctly so that it works for you. Many business owners will actually leave tech to be kind of like a scary black box that just sits in the corner. For those business owners, tech is just something that's difficult. It's something that they kind of have to fight. And so our philosophy around helping small businesses is that if we can help you get tech on your side, then we're going to help you build a better business. And we're all about you succeeding, you having more freedom, you having more flexibility in your life. And so this is how we do it. Now, we've been able to grow and scale our team, and I'm in the very lucky position myself where I have time freedom, I have location freedom. I'm currently presenting from my camper truck, which I use, and I'm currently traveling around Australia in that. I've got the ability to go different places and run my business from wherever I am. Now, I know that not everyone necessarily dreams of running your business from anywhere, but I know that for most business owners, a bit more time freedom and a bit more flexibility is definitely something that is desirable. And so that's why we do what we do. Now, we know that most businesses go through different stages of growth. And in those different stages of growth, you have different, let's say, different levels of technology adoption. And we've created something that we call the Technology Adoption Guide. And this is for small businesses to know what kind of technology you should be focusing on at the different stages of your business growth. So when you're a launch business, it's all about getting the basics done, like your password set up, get some basic backups in place. Even if you are using Google Workspace, having an external backup is a good idea. Once you progress to startup, it's about task management, storing your files and sharing them properly with your team. Growing businesses in the growth stage then need to start thinking about, well, how do our technology tools support our processes, like having a CRM in place for your sales team to make sure that, now, you know, a strict and a formal sales process is followed with your customers, and starting to open up the flexibility of remote teams. So if you want to start hiring employees internationally, then what tools and bits and pieces do you need for that? Now, ultimately, our goal is to get businesses to scale, which is to get you to 20 employees or more. And we know that when businesses have at least 20 employees working inside the business owner can actually start to get off the tools and start to actually step back a little bit and delegate things over to others. So a really great way of doing that is having enough staff that you can take off all the hats that you need to take off, and then have everybody basically working in the business for you, not you working for everyone else in the business. And that's basically the aim that we're trying to get business owners to, is through this growth roadmap, understand where you are, understand where you need to get to, and then work with our team to implement the right kind of technology to support you no matter where you are in your business journey. So today we're talking about managing multiple domains. And this kind of question usually comes up when business owners are starting to think about managing their business. And maybe you've got a side hustle. Maybe you've got multiple domains for multiple industries. Maybe you've got multiple countries that you're operating in. For whatever reason that you might want an extra domain name, Google Workspace makes it really easy for you to be able to set up multiple domains. Now, this is just done straight inside the admin panel, and it's a pretty straightforward process to actually go in there and get it set up. Pretty easy. You just go into You just go into the domains menu, and inside the domains menu, you can add multiple domains. Now, the first thing for you to understand is the difference between an add-on domain and an alias domain, because those two are very distinctly important. An add-on domain is something that allows you to have multiple names or multiple domains for the business where they are completely distinct. They are separate buckets of email. Whereas an alias domain is just like a nickname. It's an extra domain that happens to work for all of your staff. So if that's a bit hard to get your head around, let me try and give you a bit of a visual representation and a visual explanation. So imagine your email like buckets of email. Each one of your mailboxes is a different bucket of email. Now, when you have a bucket of email, it has a primary name. Everyone has one primary email address. Now, for me, mine is peter@itgenius.com. For you, yours would be your name at yourbusinessname.com. But let's say, for example, I want to set up an alias. Maybe I want to set up PM@itgenius.com, or petermoriarty@itgenius.com. When I set those up as an alias, and that is done inside the users list inside of Google Workspace admin, when I set each one of those up, they will still come into that one bucket of email. And so when I set up multiple domains and I want to use an add-on domain, add-on domains let me set up different buckets with different domains. So instead of just having my peter@itgenius.com domain, I would have to pay for an extra license, but I would get an extra peter@itgenius.biz or .com.au or .asia or .co.uk, wherever else I'd like. And that separate bucket of email would be able to receive, send emails separately. Now, that obviously makes sense if you have two different distinct mailboxes that you want to have. Now, remember, you're going to have to manage an extra mailbox for that, right? So it's completely different. Whereas an alias domain for your Google account will automatically mirror every one of your email addresses inside the account. And so let's say, for example, I have itgenius.com.au and I decide that I want to also accept emails from .com as well, but for the whole business. Well, then I would use an alias domain, just like we use an alias for the users inside of Workspace. And when I add that extra domain in there, it's automatically going to add an extra email address for each one of those users. So I'm going to show you inside the admin console how we access the different domains menu. Pretty simple. We go straight in here to domains. And then inside domains, you'll see we can manage domains. And then when we manage domains, we can add a domain or we can add a domain alias. So adding a domain is just the basic of adding an add-on domain. Remember, if you'd like to be able to create different buckets, you want to use an add-on domain. If you want to have an extra domain that is a nickname for everyone else that works the same, like a .com or a .uk, something that's going to work the same for all of the email addresses, you can add a domain alias. Now, how they show up when you go to the users console, if I open up ISA's email here, you'll see that in my domains, our primary domain is itgenius.com, and we have an alias for .asia, and we have an alias for .com.au as well. So when I open up ISA's email address, let's open up her emails. We should be able to see, let's just make sure we can find it. Of course, it's going to make a liar out of me. Now I'm not going to be able to find it. All right, let's see where it actually is. That is really bizarre because it usually will show up here as aliases. That's okay. Perhaps Google have moved it. They do this often. And it usually makes a liar out of me. Add an alternative email. Okay, cool. Here is where it actually shows up, and I'm sure my editors will clean this up for the people on the replay. By the way, those that are listening, please just drop a message in and let me know if you can hear me and see me okay. That would be awesome. I can see that Mean is watching. G'day, Mean. Yeah, just drop me a message, guys, and let me know if you can see and hear me okay. That would be awesome. All right, so here you can see that ISA has isa@itgenius.com.au automatically added as an alias. And that's grayed out there, basically because I can't edit it because it's applied right across the business. When would you choose to use an extra domain inside your account versus when would you just spin up a new G Suite account? And we get this question all the time. Business owners will come to us and say, hey, when should I use different accounts? And the key thing is to think about, will I need to one day split these accounts apart or will I need to keep these accounts together? And we're going to talk a little bit more about that in the upcoming section. So let's talk about how we can use multiple domains within a Google account, because Google have some pretty cool features. And one of those is organizational units, which allow you to actually switch on and off different features. Now, if you imagine multiple domain names as multiple buckets of email, you can also think about the domains in your Google Workspace account as different organizational units. Now, if you imagine a large organization that uses Google Workspace, like Woolworths, they'll have Woolworths, which will be one organizational unit. They have BWS, which is the liquor store. They'll have another organizational unit. They used to have a brand called Masters. That one would have had its own organizational unit. And they've got like about 300,000 users inside of Google Workspace. And they're actually one of the largest commercial customers in the world. Now, inside that business, all they need to do is configure separate organizational units inside Google Workspace to allow different access to maybe email services, to Google Drive services, or other Google features, depending on what organizational unit they're a part of. They may want to do things like set up different email features and signatures. They might want to restrict different services or features for different users. Remember that each user that's set up with a different bucket or a primary domain name is going to be able to use that primary domain name for their things like calendar invites and anything else that goes out from their email. I think one of the only restrictions is that you can't change the logo of the G Suite account or the Google Workspace account for all the users in different organizational units. But apart from that, you can pretty much have each different org unit act as different businesses. Now, why might you want to do that? Well, if you want to just keep things nice and simple and possibly even share some licenses, like you might say that someone who's working at Woolworths might also want to have a BWS email as well. And you can, even if you've added an add-on domain and separate organizational units, you can still kind of like cross-collaborate on the aliases. So that means that if company A wants to have a shared staff member and that shared staff member works for both brands, well, they can have a separate signature, they can have separate incoming and outgoing email, all from the one mailbox, and you only have to pay for one license. So in that case, it would make sense to keep everything in one Google account and then just configure and set up multiple mailboxes. Keeps things nice and simple when you do it that way. Cool. So if you have business partners involved, or you know, maybe this is a side project, you might decide, you know, differently about whether or not you want to keep everything under one account, or if you then potentially split it out into multiple accounts. And we'll have a bit more info on what's actually involved in splitting them out on multiple accounts. So last up, if you want to go ahead and add an extra domain for yourself, it's pretty straightforward. As I showed you, you go into the admin panel and you configure from the domains menu an additional domain. Now, when you click add a new domain, you're going to choose the domain. So let's go itgenius.co.uk as an example, and it's going to ask me to verify the domain ownership. Now, for this, you need to configure your DNS settings. There are instructions here on how to connect the MX records, but there's a number of other records that you need to get correct to make sure that your email are delivered correctly. And that means they're not landing in people's spam mailboxes. So for that, you need to do SPF, DKIM, and we would recommend the DMARC protocol as well. Now, if these sound confusing, it's because it's probably better to get a technical person to do them for you. If you need some help, our concierge team are very happy to help you out. Otherwise, on our YouTube channel, we have a video on how to set and configure your own DNS for your Google Workspace account. But that's a half an hour video, plus time for you to actually get it done. It's probably going to be an hour of your time. I would suspect it's better use of your time to have someone else take care of it for you. So if you're interested in that, click on the link below and jump on a free consultation with our team to see how we can help you with your Google account.